Another hot topic in the Western world is hate speech laws, and many people fear that they are de facto blasphemy laws. This is playing out in Scotland at the moment. Laws introduced, of all days, on April the 1st, which is quite ironic, to criminalise stirring up hate against protected identity groups. We've talked about this a couple of times, but just to let you know, there were more than 8,000 complaints in just the first week that these laws had been enacted. And, of course, you can make an anonymous complaint to the police, and the police have promised they will follow up every single complaint. Well, Caleb, they're now saying that 8,000 in one week, if this trajectory continues, within 9 months, hate crimes will overtake all other crimes
I love it.
Put together. Officers have been brought back from holidays to do overtime in order to chase up all of these complaints.
Oh, hang on, I reckon it's the officers making the complaints themselves.
They're generating work,
they're getting the overtime. Why wouldn't you do it?
It could be. And many of the complaints within the first 24 hours at least were against Scotland's First Minister for a speech he made in Parliament a couple of years ago where he criticised, Caleb,
white people. Yes.
He was asked about this on the BBC and whether or not that particular speech was in fact worthy of being reported as a hate crime.
For many Scots who've reported you, goes back to a speech you made in 2020 where you went through a whole series of important senior public posts in Scotland which are held by white people, and you made a very powerful point about how white. Scotland is 96% white, and there are some very active people, particularly on social media, who are saying Humza Yousaf's message was essentially racist. It was anti-white. Under the new legislation, the police also have to, as I understand it, record it as a non-criminal hate incident, and you will be named. How do you feel about that?
So a couple of points to make. The description of those who reference that speech as hatred, I've not seen anybody who has described it in that way that isn't, frankly, part of the far right.
It's interesting that the BBC interviewer called it a powerful speech when most of Scotland called it a racist speech. It tells you a lot, not just about the First Minister of Scotland, but also about the BBC. But then he has the hide to call anyone who complains far right. Is that not hate speech?
That's very Trudeau-esque, because the way the left use the term far right is to be like outsider, nut job, like whatever they say, no validity, no merit whatsoever. They're those people. Mm. And so it's a disparaging sledge that is everyone of their ilk hears and goes, oh, yeah, they're just nutcases, like forget about them. They're probably white supremacists, which also goes hand in hand with the whole far right conspiracy theorist, white supremacists, just add every single bigot, every single thing in there. He's very Trudeau-esque. He uses this a lot. Oh, these far-right people, that can't be having them, and did, in fact, during the pandemic, then list off all the things that they were, which were all the names that I just said above. So it's very dismissive. It's like literally half of the complaints that they'd received were about you and this speech. You're the First Minister, and all he can say in his defence was, well, they're just far right. Well, that means Scotland's the place for me, baby, because it sounds like there's a lot of them still there. I mean, I'm heading to Scotland. Sounds like my kind of people are all camping out there.
They're not far right. They're people simply pointing out the stupidity of the law that his government passed. They're saying, well, if you want to come for us for supposed hate speech, we're just going to turn it back on you. It's got nothing to do with far right or far left or far off on the moon. Who cares? It's about the fact you passed stupid legislation, and we're going to show you exactly how stupid it is. Now,